I fell into a burning ring of fire. I went down, 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 and the flames went higher. And it burns, 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 the ring of fire, the ring of fire.
Welcome to 10 Minutes. I'm Tony Scott, in studio with my bro, Peter Rodney.
You've never called me bro before.
It's the first for everything, right? It's the first for everything. We're going to let it go.
I don't even know if I can focus on the show anymore.
Late night, here in the studio, knocking it out. We're going to get after it. We're going to go Squirts, Pee-wees, Bantams, high school.
We're going to hit so much in the next 10 minutes, you won't know where your head is.
Or 14, depending on how fast we go. So yeah. Let's go. Today's sponsor, Little Locker Room. You were very critical of my girl's little locker room, so I'm going to hand it to you right now.
The little locker room.
You can do it way better than I can.
The little locker room is literally a lifesaver for some people. When you have multiple bags,
or just one,
they tend to stink.
Yeah.
So you throw them in the little locker room in your garage. It keeps the equipment dry so it doesn't grow mold or any bacteria.
Warm.
It keeps the smell in the garage and it keeps the equipment warm. So when little Junior has his 5:30 a.m. practice, he doesn't put on his shoulder pad and goes, "Dad, it's cold."
Nope.
So now we can say, "Dad, this is tough."
Warm, dry, stink free.
Warm, dry, stink free.
And really economical.
In four words, we have just described why you should get a little locker room.
The locker room, baby. Little locker room. All right, speaking of little, let's start with the little guys. Squirts. Two major champions were crowned. The Burnsville Scott Benedict was won by Matamidi. And the Well, I want to say Squirtacular. It's not super ranked.
It's not the
Spectacular. Nothing's the Squirtacular. Was won by Osseo Maple Grove Crimson.
Shocking.
Yeah, they beat who?
Osseo Maple Grove White.
Yeah, shocking. All right, we called that one. If we had any picks right, that was the one. That was the
master lock of the week.
A
bunch of picks right. I don't know.
You did. You got them all right. You got the
I'm out here Clay Thompsoning three.
Yes, you are. Yes, you are. I noticed a few things. Shakopee's a really good team. They got Cole Bumgarner is playing Shakopee this year. A kid named Nate Pedersen, who we saw play for Hometown last year. He's a real surefire 08. So Shakopee was pretty good, but Matamidi, I trounced them. Beat them 5-1 in the pool play and 9-1 in the championship. It's crazy how good this team is. Back on the D, they got a kid named, what's so funny?
I'm waiting for you to say his name.
Oh, Casper? I always want to say Jasper, but it's Casper Lang. He's got hair down here. He spins, he drives, he shoots, he passes. He's got the backdoor feed down to a science.
Casper the friendly Zephyr.
There's the DeMar's brothers, Ryland and Boomer. Boomer is, he's a special talent. He's a first year squirt. As rarely do you see a first year squirt take over a game. He's the kind of kid, and he's not big. He's just fast, got a great motor, fun to watch.
Boomer's a heck of a name to live up to.
Yeah, he was really good. So there it is for squirts.
There it is.
Congratulations to those champions. Prior Lake won the Hopkins Squirt A as well. So there you go.
Lakers are on a roll, isn't it?
We are. Yes, they are. Switching gears to PBAA, your favorites won again at Eden Prairie, Woodbury. And Tanner Zalnowski, who we've known for years, is to be a great player.
Been around for a while.
He is, and we didn't see him at the Big Pumpkin, and partly the reason they didn't take first or get to the championship of the Big Pumpkin. I think they are the number two team in the state. We have them ranked there behind the juggernaut, Chaska Chan. They win the first test of the rest or best or whatever it is.
Woodbury's thrilled to have Tanner back from football.
Yeah, very, very thrilled. PBB, we hosted one. What was your takeaway with Osseo Maple Grove winning there? What was one of the couple keys of that team winning?
Well, Osseo Maple Grove's defense was huge. I mean, those kids in skates averaged about 6 feet. And in addition to being so tall, they had the long reach, and they were able to poke the puck off opposing sticks, and they didn't have to sacrifice playing the body at all.
And they had two good goaltenders. They had Steenison, mm-hmm. who won the game in a shootout in the semifinals.
And Dreifke.
So, I mean, this is a really good team. I want to say they're going to lock to win the state title, but they have a good coach.
We're a long way off.
They got three good lines. They got great D. This is a tough team to beat come districts and regions, for sure.
I would not disagree.
How about Bantam Bee now?
Bantam Bee.
Sticking with the same theme.
Bantam Bee is an interesting one. Because last season we saw a kid named Chayton Fisher,
yep.
who played
in the tournament.
Maple Grove's Bantam Bee. He played in last year's Gobbler, and now this year he is a huge contributor to the Bantam AA team.
I mean, he's a shootout goal away from being the MVP of the Blue Ox.
So Bantam Bee, nothing to sneeze at talent-wise.
No, especially this one.
This Minnetonka team, this is a repeat champion yep. from last season. Great goaltending in Quinn Gergen, a great performance by Gavin Gary, who was named tournament MVP. This Minnetonka Skipper's Bantam Bee team could be providing some names to next year's Bantam AA squad.
In Minnetonka, no doubt about it. Well, a lot of these kids did play. I know for a fact, Gary played PBAA last year. Brooke. What's his last
name? Burke Sullivan.
Thank you. Met his dad in the lobby. Super nice guy. I called him Sully by the end of the weekend.
Oh gosh.
So Burke Sullivan. Yeah, he was another PBAA that's there. So there's plenty of good talent at this level. Same with Edina. There's plenty of kids at Edina as well doing the same thing. Charlie Hoke and
Colin Dorsey.
Yeah, those kids are all. These are really good talented players. So, congrats to Minnetonka for repeating in the Gobbler. Now we'll go to Bantam AA. Your pick. You got it right again. I went double EP. Neither one of the EPs came through. And Prior Lake wins another championship. Are you going to pick them again in the spirit of Duluth?
You have no idea. Find out in about 2 minutes.
2 minutes down the road. So anyway, so we move out of Bantams into boys high school. We had our tournament, the opener. Any takeaways from you on Minnetonka?
St. Thomas Academy. First.
Yeah, okay.
Mrs. Brendan McFadden and Luke Herzog.
Really bad.
Two players, but they add depth, they add size. Minnetonka's defense this year this wasn't even our observation. This was someone else who's close to the program who said their defense might be better
this year
than last season.
You could argue that.
Josh Lidke is a man on a mission.
Yeah, he is. Greenway beats Rapids in an inner city rivalry there.
Inter-city.
They are rivals. I talked to Coach Grant Clafton today up in Coleraine. Actually lives in Grand Rapids, oddly enough. He tells me that that game, his cousin, actually Carter Clafton, was a big reason the score stayed this close. Because he said, you know, he was a great goaltender. Watch out for Rapids. They'll be a good squad. I still think I have, in our staff rankings, I have Greenway as the number one A team in the state.
Love them.
One more great story, I think, high school-wise, comes out of Plymouth. Maple Grove wins the turkey trot.
I have to put it in quotes.
Wins.
They tie
and they won
Whatever.
In a shootout.
They won in a shootout.
So it was great to see some of those young guns, Henry Nelson, Justin Janicki, Kyle Kukkonen, kind of doing the things that we've seen them do for the last 6 years in the youth.
Well, now they're doing it at high school. That's a statement to everyone who thought that group might need a year of an adjustment period.
No adjustment.
Nearly every sophomore on that roster played serious minutes, and Kyle Kukkonen scored in the shootout. Ethan Elias assisted on a goal in the championship game.
Here they are.
The kids are all grown up.
Yep, they're all grown up. It's kind of nice to see. Oh, you're crying? All right. It's snowing outside. So we're getting to our favorite
My
commute's segment.
Gonna be like 2 hours.
What's your favorite snow activity?
My favorite snow activity is to climb the massive snow piles in the Cub Foods parking lot at Harmar Mall. They create three huge piles of snow. And as a kid, I used to like to sneak into the parking lot with my friends, and we would climb the mountains, and we would try to slide down, and then Waylon security would come buzzing around in their jeeps, and we would hide in the little hill, and it felt like we had our own little kingdom.
These favorite segments, it's just never cease to amaze.
You're learning so much about me.
It's great.
I think I'm going to go to Cub after this.
All right. There's not enough snow for snow piles out there, buddy.
I can dream.
Okay. My favorite snow activity is shoveling. I love shoveling the rink. I love shoveling the sidewalks. I just love clearing snow, getting out there, getting out in the elements.
You think that's why people love painting?
Maybe.
Immediate gratification
for
your brain.
It's
like building a Lego set.
I like that kind of stuff. All right, there's a lot of activity coming up.
There okay? is.
Let's talk about the Spirit of Duluth. You'll be up in Duluth.
I will.
So remember now, every pick that you make, there's going to be 15 teams who are going to like throw eggs at you this weekend.
That's fair.
I'm not going to be there. So when I take Edina across the board, no one's going to get mad at me.
A way to give it away.
Yeah, all right. Well, I'm going to pick Edina across the board.
You're the kid who peaked at present.
Band double A, I'm going Edina. I think they're going to get they're going to be a little hungrier than prior, just going based on hunger factor. Edina didn't win down in Chicago. This is their second tournament. They're hungry. They've only played a handful of games here in Minnesota. Mm-hmm. Prior Lakes played tons of games. They've won two tournaments. They're not going to be as hungry as the Hornets. I'll take the Hornets there.
I'm going to take Prior Lake.
Shocker. Are they your new Woodbury?
Sometimes you got to dance with the one that brung you. Yeah, right. Prior Lake has earned me two.
Hard to argue with that. They have two unbelievable frontline scoring. So you can't really match
up. They
figured
out how to win in these tournament formats.
I agree. All right, PBAA, I'm going down to you. They've played, for the exception of a tie with Minnetonka, the last 3 weeks, they might be as hot as Woodbury, and there's no Woodbury in this, so you're going to have to go digging deep to come up with another team.
I almost didn't pick anyone in protest.
Just, okay, who
so I went with Woodbury's best friends, the Hermantown
They are
Hawks.
Best friends.
I'm going to take Hermantown. Short drive, no bus
Planet
legs.
Home.
You get to sleep in your own bed.
I like that pick. I like that pick. No love for Thunder Bay.
I like this Thunder Bay team.
They're in the Edina bracket. Be careful, Hornets. They got a good squad. They came down to Duluth a few weeks ago and did a number on a few teams.
And
so
depending on how the game is called, one team is going to have to adapt. Either the Canadians are going to have to adapt to the American way of playing the game, or the Americans are going to have to adapt to the Canadian way of playing the game. And whoever refuses to adapt or doesn't adapt quickly enough, it's going to go down.
This is going to be a matchup of two unbelievable goaltenders when they play. Landon Palmgren from Edina and Carter George from Thunder Bay. I guarantee it's a 2-1, 1-0 type soccer score type score.
You're going to take a low scoring game?
I'll take take the under. Take the under in Vegas on that one.
Well, Vegas says it's... I won't go in.
Hot game. So that's a hot game, and I think that's the hottest game in the PBAA. What's the hottest game in the Bantam AA?
I really like Wyzetta Prior Lake. And not just because it's going to look like they're wearing each other's jerseys.
It's going to be like an inter-squad scrimmage.
There's going to be friggin' gold helmets everywhere.
No, they don't wear it. Neither association wears gold. There are a couple gold still out there at the Bantam B and PBB. I haven't seen it. Navy.
Well, that's kind of a bummer.
Going Navy.
I wanted to see Golden Domers everywhere.
No,
I think Wyzetta Prior Lake is going to be the best.
That'll be a good game.
Double A game.
No doubt about it.
Unfortunately, it's played at 10:15 in the morning.
All right.
On Friday.
Now, Section 6 and Section 8A are having like an inter-squad tournament this weekend in the St. Cloud area.
Jamboree.
It's going to be awesome. It's not really. It's not licensed that way or even promoted that way.
They're regular season.
East Grand Forest plays St. Cloud Cathedral on Saturday.
That's
and
great.
World plays Sartell. This is two great games played within an hour of each other. We have two separate staff members in two separate buildings, and the games are an hour apart. Who do you like in the East Grand St. Cloud Cathedral game?
That's so tough.
East Grand is tough.
Gets
They're both top 10.
Back after an injury. They bring up a solid defenseman in Trey Osmus from that.
He got two goals last weekend.
He's another one of those freshmen who does not play like a freshman.
No.
I'm going to take East Grand for
it. I'm not sure Landon Parker will be back. I have not gotten the injury report submitted
He's on the roster,
but he did not play last weekend. So I would assume he won't be there until I get a text message from the 218. All right. I think St. Cloud Cathedral comes back seasoned. They come back hungry, not making the state tournament last year. I'm going Cathedral Crusaders on this one.
Who do you like in War Road Sartell?
World got beat by Bemidji in their lone game. Sartell's hasn't been tested. This is a really hard pick 'em. I'm just going to go reach in a hat and I'm going to go World.
Sartell me another joke. I'll take the Sabres in this one.
Right.
Sartell has had a very underrated youth program over the past several years, and that talent is starting to trickle up to the high school.
They got great sophomores. They have a great senior class and a good sophomore class. I think this is a team that can really do some damage this year. They could win Section 6A, which is the toughest section, if you ask me, which includes Little Falls, Alexandria, and Cathedral. So, good luck.
Yeah, Sartell, they're also playing at home.
All right, last before we hit the booms and the game pucks, Creighton Durham Hall and Eden Prairie, that game will be live streamed on YHH. Who are you liking that one? Again, both teams haven't played. Both have star power.
I like Eden Prairie.
Ooh, I do too.
I think Eden Prairie's star power outweighs Creighton Durham Hall's star power, but I think Mac Leeson will be the best player on the ice.
I think that
I covered every single.
I'm going to pick Eden Prairie as well. We could go double on this one. Give them the Goocher, and we could go down on this one. I'm not sure. What do you got for Boom Roasted?
I have a Boom Roasted.
I like this one. If this is the Bantam one, it's really good.
I'm almost anti opening the door for Pee-wees, but I understand there are some Pee-wees who legs just aren't tall enough.
Did you see Junior Podine hopping boards?
He would do it.
No, he would.
The kid is enough of a gamer where he would hop
boards. I know.
If you are opening the doors for Bantams, you might as well tie their skates and carry their bag into the rink. A roller bag, and then greet them with a Gatorade and a pretzel after the game. Stop opening the doors for Bantam players. They are old enough to climb the boards.
All right.
And you know how many too many men on the ice penalties you would avoid by not having someone standing there with the door open?
Are you done?
Nah.
End it with Boom Roasted. End it with Boom Roasted.
Roast Boom.
Boom Roasted. All right, my Boom Roasted goes to a few parents that may have gotten a little out of hand at our tournament, and that's all I'm going to say. Don't get out of hand at youth tournaments.
Gosh.
Guess who's watching? Not just the other parents, but the worst part, your kids are watching. Okay? Your kids are watching. Boom Roasted.
Boom Roasted.
All right. Game pucks. You got one?
Do I have a game puck?
Game pucks.
I'm going to let you go first, and we'll see if one comes to me.
All right. My game puck goes out to all of the tournament directors on Thanksgiving weekend. Okay, I was talking to a friend this week. He goes, "Oh, I had the most relaxing Thanksgiving. We were family, and we did all this stuff." I'm like,
"I just want to punch those people."
I worked all weekend, and you worked all weekend, and then you go to Eden Prairie, and there's these people working all weekend. You go to Burnsville, you go to Edina, and there's all these volunteers pouring in hours and hours of work during the Thanksgiving holiday. So my game puck goes out to all the volunteers at all these youth tournaments this past weekend.
If I got to give a game puck out, I would give the game puck to the high school teams that participated in our opener tournament to start the season. We had nothing but fond memories on the ice. We saw a couple of great games. The kids were really well behaved. The coaches were there for whatever we needed, for post-game interviews and for little tidbits for our broadcast. So to the high school teams who made their way to Bloomington over the weekend, we salute you. Here's a game puck.
The broadcasts were great. The between periods interviews with the kids it was an unbelievable experience. Hosting high school players, we're hosting another one in December.
And all those kids for life. First varsity goals.
Lots of
we
them.
We gave out so many game pucks this week.
6 or 7 first varsity goals. Those are always a blast. It was a blast doing a show with you today, Peter. Great job putting it together. For Peter Odney, I'm Tony Scott. We'll see you next week.
I fell into a burning ring of fire. I went down, 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 and the flames went higher. And it burns, 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 the ring of fire.